These are my 10 favorite tools that I purchased on Amazon in 2023, but there's two I regret buying. Let's go. If you like any of the tools you see today, I'll drop a link in the description and the pinned comment so you can find them easier. In no particular order, but first on the list, this is the Infinity Router Bit Vise. If you don't have one of these, this is one of those tools you'll be absolutely glad you've got it when you need it. I love this little tool, and it's only about $35. The last time I showed this, it sold out rather quickly. What I love about this tool is the fact that you can take any router bit, quarter, 8mm, or half inch shank, stick in there on the loosened side, and you'll be able to change out your bearings. In other words, it will not go to the left when you go lefty-loosey, and it will not allow the bit to rotate to the right when you go righty-tighty. That's one of the great things about this. Super easy to change out bearings without having to use some other tool like a pair of pliers to hold your router bits. You don't want to mar that shank. Some people suggest you can leave them in the router to do this, but you still have to push the button to lock the thing. It's just easier to use this than trying to leave it in the router to change them out, and I like having this in the shop. Anytime I get ready to change out a bearing, I'm glad I've got this. Next on the list are a few different tools. We'll go ABC here. A, the DeWALT Atomic Brand Drill and Driver Set. If you don't know, DeWALT has a few different lines of their cordless tools. You got regular, everyday DeWALT cordless tools, and then you have the Atomic line, then you have the XR. I think the Atomic line is the best for most people. And I purchased these on Amazon because I got a really good deal on them, which you typically do on Amazon. These are fantastic. I find myself reaching and grabbing these for projects, for use around the house. They're just lightweight, and the batteries last a long time. I'm just rocking the 1.5 amp hour batteries. I do have some 5 amp hour batteries as well. They have plenty of power for the shop, and they just work well. And they're super comfortable to hold. They're not overly heavy. Just fantastic set of drills and impact. Now, B is the router. This is the XR line router. I think they have a lower router, but this is a fantastic router. I even built a whole mini router table around this thing. It is fantastic. I love this little router. I have several routers in the shop. The DeWALT is one of my favorites, probably between the Milwaukee and the DeWALT, but the DeWALT line is fantastic, especially for this. Plenty of power, plenty of battery life. Love having this in the shop. Now C is a recent addition, is the DeWALT Track Saw. This is a 60 volt track saw, so it's not in the 20 volt line. You can't use a 20 volt battery in here. I don't know why, but the 60 volt battery will work on these others. Doesn't make sense. This is a really good track saw with a few little quirks. It's probably the weirdest track saw or the weirdest tool DeWALT makes. However, that doesn't make it bad because I'm weird too. So I have actually enjoyed having this in the shop so far, along with the other ones. I have a whole video review on this saw already you can go check out. It's bad boy, got some power. But it is a very powerful saw that works really well with a few little quirks. It's weird, I'm weird. It's okay, go check the video out if you're interested in the track saw. But overall, the DeWALT cordless line on Amazon has been some of my favorite tools I've purchased this year. Next up, one of my favorite things I purchased on Amazon in 2023 was this Paolini pocket rule set. I purchased the entire set myself. Woodpeckers has never given me a tool or sponsored a video. I'm just very impressed with their quality, mainly because any woodpecker tool, no matter if it's a ruler or a square, you can line them up and all their measurements match each other exactly. They're extremely accurate, and that's what I appreciate about them, and they're made in the USA, so who can beat that? This is the set. You get the 7, 9, and 13 inches, how long they actually are. I think they list them a little different, so maybe 6, 8 and 12, but they're actually a little longer than that. You shouldn't do that with yours. But these are fantastic because of the slide rule or stop. You'll be able to do repeatable measurements, set depths of aprons, legs, all kinds of stuff with that. I also like the end scale they have on there. You can set up bit heights, things like that with it. It's very handy. They'll set up by themselves using that slide rule inserted into the hole. And they're just high quality tools that you will not regret buying. Now, truthfully, I mostly use this smaller one, but I do appreciate and like having all of the options here in the shop because from time to time, I want the longer rulers. You got to check these out if you're into high quality woodworking tools and you don't mind spending a little bit more for that quality. Now, this might not be a tool you were expecting in this video, but if you make videos for your customers or you're posting on Instagram, TikTok, YouTube, Facebook, good audio in your videos will level up your game and get you more reach because it's better quality. And people will watch a video with more quality audio before they'll watch a video with less video quality, if that makes sense. Now, these are some of the best mics I've ever bought, and it's thanks to my editor, Chris. Thank you, sir. He recommended these DJI mics. They're wireless, that's huge in video production, and they're easy to set up. They're literally plug and play. They'll work in your phone, they'll work on a standard camera, and they have a little touch screen on there to tweak the settings to your audio liking. I paired mine with this Shure lavalier mic so that I get this mic up here. But if you don't want that, they clip onto your shirt, they can clip onto your hat. They have a little magnet that clips through the shirt. These are fantastic. And they have charging case similar to like an AirPod, so you could travel with them, use them on the road, use them in the shop. The battery life lasts forever. These are fantastic if you're making content. One thing I love about these mics is the fact that you get two wireless mics per pack. So if you're doing interviews or if you just have two people on camera, they can each have their own mic. This is awesome to have. Listen, I've tried cheaper models than this. I've tried other brands than this. These are by far, of my 7 years of content making, the best I've ever used and easiest. Next up, I hate math, just so you know. I'm not good at it, I don't like it, but in woodworking, you have to do math. And this is why I like this little Construction Master Pro. It's a fairly inexpensive calculator for what you're getting because it'll do fractions, inches, etc. And a lot of times, when we're building projects, you have to input those fractions, add them up just to get the correct dimensions so that your project comes out correct, especially when you're trying to fit a project into a space or just trying to add up all of your materials so that you know you got enough when you go to build the project. That's why I like this little jewel, and it's not that expensive. There's even a quick reference guide on the inside to help you out. It's easy to use, and that's why I like it. And if you're into roofing or you have to build stairs, there's options for that on there as well, for pitch, rise, run, etc., as well as the stairs. You can either do circles, arcs, it'll basically do it all. I know, we all mostly have smartphones in our pocket, and you can find some online calculator to help you do that, but it's much easier just to grab this in the shop, in my opinion, punch in a few measurements, and there we go. Next up is a tool I bought so you didn't have to. I did a whole video on this. You can just search 731 REEKON M1. This thing goes on almost any miter saw, and it's a very, very accurate way to measure your parts. So if you're looking for precision, this is the way to go. I detailed that in that video, but it's super simple. You just clip it onto most any miter saw fence. You calibrate it right out of the box. Fairly simple to do. Just check out my video, and then off to the races you go. If you need to repeat parts down to the 32nd or even smaller, this might be your best option because you're not gonna rely on tape measure error or anything like that. It's fully digital, works really, really well. Now, there's a couple of caveats you may wanna check out in that video, but for a lot of people, this is a good option for a tool. Now, is it worth it for the price tag? That's really up to you. I think it's a good buy for certain situations, especially if you're looking for precision and accuracy, which are two different things. So I learned. Next, one of my favorite routers I've ever bought. I bought this year on Amazon. I already had one of these in the router table, but I bought this one to do a review versus the DeWALT. This is an excellent option for a router, especially for the price. For right around $200, you get the fixed and plunge base with this router and a hard case for storage or carry. And this thing is absolutely awesome. I love this router. It's one of my favorite routers that I've ever used, including the DeWALT. But as far as awesome goes, I really like how this, especially the plunge base, worked. I have a whole video comparing the two if you want to check those out. But this is an absolutely fantastic 2.25 horsepower router that will accept 1/4 and 1/2 inch collets. I don't think you could go wrong with this, and it's one of my favorites of 2023. Even though it's been out for a very long time, this is a tried and true proven router that'll last you for years. If you've watched this channel any time at all, you know I'm a huge fan of the Festool Sander. This ETS 125 is by far one of my favorites. But if you're on a budget or you're not ready to step into a higher end sander, because this one's $250. This one is under $100, usually right around $80. This is the DeWALT Sander. This sander won my best sander under $100 in that video because of the features, how well it sands, the least vibration, the dust collection. This is just a good all-around sander that's gonna last you for a very long time. When I first started woodworking, I tried to cheap out and bought a hyper tough sander. It only lasted about a month or so. And then I went and spent $79 or $80 on this DeWALT sander, and it lasted for years and years and years. And then I replaced it with this one for that video so that I could have all new sanders so that it was a fair test. This is a good option for a sander if you're getting into woodworking or you just want to upgrade from maybe one of the more budget options. This is a good solid option for you and is one of the best of 2023 from Amazon, in my opinion. next up, I bought this earlier this year, did a whole video on it, but the Wind Oscillating Spindle and Belt Sander is a fantastic tool to have in the shop. It's literally a game changer, especially if you're doing small parts or parts that have curves, radiuses, anything like that. I love this little tool for the price, and it's a Wind product, which some people frown on, but I've had really good luck with Wind tools. I still have the Wind drill press that I still use in the shop. I've had multiple different Wind tools over the years. I think it's a really good deal for the price. And the fact that you can swap out the belt for the spindle, it's very much like the rigid spindle and belt sander, but at a much lower price. Plenty of power. It has better dust collection, in my opinion, than the rigid. I just think it's a really good all-around tool and one of the best I've purchased in 2023 from Amazon. If you're interested in the whole video review, you just search Wind Spindle Sander 731. You'll find it. Just a really good tool to have in the shop. Don't forget, I've got those two tools that I regret buying from Amazon, but this one I absolutely do not. This is the Skil router and router table combo. You can get this for less than $200 almost all the time. I think I gave 170 something for it. This is a really good package deal if you need a small router and router table for your shop. I like this tool. I thought it had a lot of power. The only real drawback I found was the fact that the fence was a little hard to adjust if you're trying to joint boards or anything like that. But if you're just cutting grooves, rabbits, dados, this will work just fine. And the fact that it's great for roundovers and small parts makes this an excellent choice. And the router can be taken out of there, so you can use that as a regular fixed base router if you wish for anything that you need routed. And these are really good routers for the price. I think this is one of those hidden gems on Amazon that a lot of people kind of pass over because it's a Skil brand. But I think you get a lot for your money here for less than $200. But I think this is a great beginner or intermediate level router and router table combo. Now I regret buying this from Amazon. This was a total waste of my money. Can you tell which one's the Woodpeckers from there? Maybe, probably. This is the Woodpeckers brand. This is the Amazon knockoff of this. I wasted my money on this. I want you to hear the difference. I don't wanna drop this too far. Metal. I thought this was gonna be metal. It looked like metal on the description. I didn't read the description, I just bought it. It's plastic. This is a cheap piece of crap. And you can tell it doesn't, it won't even square up when you tighten this down. This is a child's toy. As far as a combination square, there are much better alternatives out there. I love the indexable square from Woodpeckers, but it is very expensive. I'll let you look at the price and have a heart attack later. But this is a very, very cheap, very terrible tool. Now, Swanson makes an excellent combination square that will not break the bank. It's a good quality tool, as well as Starrett brand makes a very good quality combination square that will kind of break the bank. Just depends on where you're at in your budget and if you want to spend money on these type tools, but absolutely avoid this one. I'll link it in the description so you can go laugh at it, but bad, bad, bad. And the number two tool I regret buying is this little trim square. Now there are several trim squares out there that I much prefer, including the Swanson, the DFM, even the Woodpeckers Delve squares are awesome little squares. But this one I kind of find odd. This is a Johnson square, and it works, it's square, it's fine for that. But these little notches in there aren't very accurate. If you're trying to lay out accurate lines in woodworking, then this is not, in my opinion, a good square for that. This may be good for rough construction or framing, etc. But for us woodworkers, I just don't think this is a good option. Even though I didn't spend a lot of money on this, I regret buying it. Check out the all-time top 10 tools I've ever bought on Amazon, ever, not just in 2023, right there. Click in the box, get you the big old virtual fist bump. Thank you for watching.